Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com, and here's how I use the Notes app on my Mac and iPhone. MacMost is brought to you thanks to a great group of more than 1,000 supporters. Go to MacMost.com/Patreon. There you can read more about the Patreon campaign, join us, and get exclusive content and course discounts. So here's another video in my productivity series showing you how I use the different apps and things you can do on your Mac and iPhone to stay organized, get work done. So for the Notes app, I probably don't use it as much as some other people do. I know people have sometimes hundreds of notes. They use them for all sorts of different things. I tend to put lots of information in files instead. But I do use the Notes app for some really interesting things that I thought I'd share with you. So this is all in my demo account, and I've tried to recreate some of the lists I use in my real account. So for instance, one of the things I've got is a list of home contractor notes of various people that handle things like HVAC, plumbers, somebody to clean the gutters, fix the garage door if it breaks, somebody to paint things, all of that. And what I do is I put it all in this one note here. So I have easy access to it, but also I can share this note and share it with my wife so that she has access to it at any time. So if I'm not around and she needs to call a plumber, she knows to go right to this note and all the information's right there. Now another way I use shared notes is for trip planning. This was a trip from back in 2019. I'll share it with everybody else that's going on the trip, and we can all add things here. Little links to hikes, to restaurants, to things to do. Put them all in here. We can all comment on them, say what we like, don't like. One of us can go in and organize it at some point. And we can all share this stuff. That way you could tell somebody, hey, I found a great thing for us to do. I added it to the note. So when we actually go on the trip, we have easy access to all of this. So we can easily get directions. There are phone numbers. If we schedule something, there's the time and everything's right there, all shared between us. I also create lots of packing lists. And this may seem like it's something to do in reminders, but reminders, you check something off and then it kind of disappears off the list. The great thing about doing it in notes is first I could have it in sections and I could have headings on top of those sections. I could have actual notes, underneath each thing here so I can type something else. And I can kind of organize very easily this way. And also, as I check things off, I'm preparing for this trip. But after this trip's over, I could easily reset this whole list and get it ready for next time. Here's another such list. This is a backpacking list. So I've got a different one for going on a hike here in Colorado than for actually going overseas and doing something. I have another checklist for home security when I go on a trip or leave for any reason. I have all the different things here that I need to check before I leave. Like most people, I'm probably always worried I'm going to forget that one thing. Oh, to lock the back gate or to turn on a security camera or something like that. Another house-oriented thing I've got is for the fuse box. An old house, I've got this big fuse box back there. It's got a bunch of numbers and really no labels telling you what the fuse goes to. So when I need to actually shut power off to a room, say to change a light switch or something, I will experiment, figure out which one it is, and then I'll add it to this list. So eventually this list will include all of the fuse numbers. What makes this list really handy as a note instead of anything else like a text file, for instance, is that I most often need to access this on my phone. I need to get to it really quickly. The same for a lot of these. Here's another one that kind of fits that. Sometimes when we go to restaurants, spend a lot of time trying to figure out what I like on the menu, and then we don't go there for a few more months, and then I can't remember what it was I got last time that I liked so much. So I'll actually put these things here. And then here's a note that I've got that I think a lot of people have, like a movies and TV shows recommended list, right? Because somebody tells you, oh, you got to see this movie, you got to watch this TV show. And even if you like the recommendation, you know you're not going to get around to it for a while because you're already watching something. So you want to put these in a note. The real note's actually much more detailed with a lot more information. And then I could easily kind of make something bold or move it to the top of the list if it's something that I should really watch soon. So those are some of the notes that I create that I find useful. I'd love to hear from you to find out what type of notes you have. If you liked this video, click the thumbs up button below to let me know. I publish new tutorials each weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out.